Fireworks. How do they work? This is a model of an aerial shell, a typical firework used by pyrotechnicians, which are firework experts. Shell casings are assembled using cardboard and paper mache. At the top, you have the string loop. This holds the quick match fuse in place. The fuse is a cotton string containing gunpowder, also known as black powder. The black powder usually consists of potassium nitrate, charcoal, and sulfur. Starting the firework is as simple as lighting the quick match fuse. The lit fuse runs along the length of the shell until it reaches the lift cup. Cross match surrounds the end of the fuse to ensure a successful burn. Within the lift cup, you have the aptly named lift charge, which is also black powder. Once lit, the powder in the cup rapidly ignites, producing gases which propels the shell skyward while simultaneously igniting the timer fuse. A straw encompasses the timer fuse, which guarantees only the center of the shell is ignited, providing a controlled and uniform explosion. The longer the timer fuse takes to burn, the higher the shell will travel. The shell continues traveling until the lit straw fuse reaches the center of the shell. The burst charge is then ignited and rapidly burned, creating an overpressure within the shell. This pressure causes the shell to break, providing a familiar explosion and igniting the spherical stars. The inner stars provide the main burst, the outer stars provide the additional breaks. Both the arrangement and composition of stars provide the illustrious colours and sounds of fireworks. Altering the stars can provide a near unlimited number of firework patterns. A star is composed of a fuel, an oxidizer, metal salts, and a binder. A fuel, in this case, black powder. The powder produces the explosion and gives fireworks their distinctive sound. An oxidizer, which produces oxygen required for the star to burn. There are numerous options available. Metal salts, these will give the explosion the characteristics you will see and hear. And a binder, which holds the various components of a star together. Sugar or starch are typically used. Naturally, fireworks are designed to travel a specific trajectory. For bottle rockets, a simple stick is used to ensure the rockets stay aligned when launched. For aerial shells, a mortar rack must be used. There are various designs and materials used, from cardboard to metal. The thickness, size, and material depend on the size of the shell. A shell is placed inside a mortar, the quick match fuse reaching out from the top. When the shell is launched, the whole rack will shake violently. Therefore, the shell fuses must be slacked, allowing for movement during this motion. A strain relief technique can be employed, such as this quick release method. Each shell's fuse is wire stripped and plugged into a rail-like circuit board. The rail contains electronic matches, which will set off to quick match fuse. These rails can be linked to a computer, in which special pyrotechnic software can set off individual shells at specific times, and can even be synced to music.